Hello, everybody. Scott Golden here with the Golden Opportunities Coaching YouTube channel. Welcome to those of you who are new and the Pro Wrestling Logic YouTube channel where you are now. This is the NWA Power Surge results for the Build the Crockett Cup, focusing on this year's Crockett Cup tournament and the upcoming NWA World Heavyweight title match. This is for 3/15/2022. Opening moments of Power Surge this week featured Joe Galli, Billy Corgan, and Pat Kenny going over the seedings for the Crockett Cup. This year's first seed was La Rebellion, and announced Harry Smith would be Doug Williams' partner in the tournament. The rest of the brackets can be seen by just kind of putting things forward. The play-in, Hawkshare at the end, Strictly Business, Gold Rush, The Begotten, and Doug Williams and Harry Smith are the teams in the tournament. After running down the teams, they go to a previously recorded match, Jay Spade defeating Sal Rinaldo with Danny Deals. Rinaldo's demon-possessed thing is kind of goofy, but he's trying to make it work. Joe Galli suggested that he was Sinister Sal Rinaldo and taking the name. Danny Deal still being in his corner doesn't really make sense. Rinaldo bit the fingers and attacks the hand of Spade in the early part of the contest, including doing several stomps, Bryan Danielson style, on Spade. Every time Spade gets offense, Sal goes for the fingers, continues small joint manipulation, and leaving Spade in the corner, Sal changed his sky high spine buster for the pinfall win. Billy Corgan and Joe Galli talk about Trevor Murdoch losing the NWA title to Matt Cardona. Corgan announced that due to the injuries suffered in the match, Murdoch is not cleared to wrestle at the Crockett Cup. Nick Aldis instead stepped in to take on Cardona, and Corgan explained Murdoch to come back stronger than he ever did once he heals up. Corgan tells the story decently here, and anyway. Allison Kay defeats Misa Kate. Kay and Kate have a decent enough match. A little bit of hope spots from Kate. NWA basically trying to get the less established talent over a little bit and giving them a shine before Kay looks decent in the match. Kate then looks like someone's who doesn't have experience but has a lot of talent and can eventually come forward. Kay gets the win after Kate misses a corkscrew splash, allowing Kay to hit the AK-47 finish. Corgan, Pat Kenny, and Joe Galli continue discussing the rest of the tournament brackets for the Crockett Cup. And Corgan is good at telling the story of the fixtures. We're with Joe Galli, and they talk about meeting up OGK, calling them nerds with a K, but the K is silent. Wrecking Ball calls out the Bushwhackers, Demolition, Legion Doom, and the Nasty Boys. And obviously Wrecking Ball trying to get some degree of buzz around his very unique character. Judas defeats with Sinister Minister defeats Jamie Stanley. Judas is a very flat wrestler, and gets worse by the time. Kills Stanley in the match. Stanley basically is a good bump dummy, but the match is heel versus heel, which is just pointless. Judas then hits a butterfly suplex into the turnbuckles on Stanley. And then basically, it almost looks like a paradigm shift gone wrong. Stanley manages flying crossbody on Judas, and then Judas grabs him by the throat, choke slams him. Judas picks him up and out of the pin, and goes for the crucifix for the win. Nick Aldis and Matt Cardona join Joe Galli for the final face-off, closing the show. Aldis and Cardona are decent enough here. Aldis then talks about how he wanted to step away from the spotlight in the world title scene, but bringing Doug Williams to go after the tag team titles. Aldis then said Murdoch deserved the spotlight and Cardona robbed him of it. Cardona claims that he was saving the NWA. Aldis said he agreed with Cardona on one thing: the NWA needs saving now, and Cardona was a clown. Aldis was very good in the promo here and a short close to the show. We'll be back with more right after this.